it says that there can be no motion to end debate until debate has occurred. A motion for immediate consideration is a bid you have had to suspend it, but in debate, all this rule change does is to say that until it's been debated, there can be no immediate consideration. And I'll share briefly with you a story out in the South before you can brief up very rarely do. But one of the reasons why I learned this bill, we get down here in this newly refurbished bubble. That's very nice, but it's a bubble. And all of a sudden, things that seem pretty clear to us aren't clear to people not down here up in the alley. And the example, the story that I played with was from the session. We were down here, I did some things every day, some other members did some things, said motions and rules, and you know, we were all in the regular role of doing that. And I had a group here from Barnum Middle School. And afterwards, I had to go back to them, and they started asking me those questions. And so, why did you do this? And why did you do that? And I think, you know, what's the rule? And what I found out is that wasn't good enough. They didn't understand why the way that they read about the way their government functions in the cities was the way that we teach them. They didn't understand why the government doesn't actually operate that way. And honestly, if one of any vote ever and anything ever did, it was the most realistic moment of saying, it was a gut check moment for me. And I'm speaking pretty frankly today, I think a lot of us need to go through the gut check based on some of the stuff I've seen here today. Now, you're all my friends, we're going to leave here. I think we're going to have some of the best of the world in this chamber across every side of it. And we're going to walk out and talk after we're going to be friends. But that doesn't mean that we can't disagree here. And I'll just tell you, if that same group of our middle school students' decision was for today, I feel even more embarrassed than I did for the head of the board here. And I think we need to gut check that as a body. And this bill is a very small part of that. Anybody, if you go out and ask anybody on the street where you're from, if this makes sense to them, they will tell you yes. And we're all here to represent them. And so I'll be happy to answer your questions, and I appreciate you coming.
As part of what we're doing, as part of Robert's Rules of Order, and we are trying to change and amend part of Robert's Rules of Order. Can you agree with that?
Robert doesn't represent this at 8-5. I represent my people, and I think they think this can be the rule change.
Well, you know, Robert has not been elected, but he has also been the main baseline for many elected organizations across the nation and the world. So, I mean, if we change part of Robert's laws, then what are we going to do? Are we going to change something?
You testified several times back in session that you thought our forefathers were well thought of and that you respected their ideas. And now you're going against what testimony you did back in session on several occasions. So did you answer, well, what's different now than back when you were saying?
To my knowledge, Thomas Jefferson, North James Madison, consulting the writing of the rule book that governs his body. And I respect their opinions on the Constitution, but these are our rules, and I think we can't prove them.
Maybe I didn't know if you were going to turn the bills over that,
and
we
were talking
about it. I have a motion
here to talk.
Thank you.
Mr. Burris, is that well? Mr. Cooper, see
you next time.
One has to do with constituents who contacted me and asked for another date. between votes. That they would get more time to contact me and find out what's going on with the bill. The second reason is we're ending the, no terminals at this point. All the people that were not terminally previously, this is the end for them. And we're going on, all of us being here for 6 years. 6 years is a short period of time, and I don't think it hurts at all to slow it down 24 hours and consider the bill. I would appreciate you voting on this.
Is everyone voting? Is everyone voting? Yes, it's a balance, correct? I vote 30 yeas, 51 nays, and 2 present, and fails, and not, and not voting. Are there any other amendments?